delicious. Well, that was quick.
You look like you could use some rest.
I'll be fine. It's just that playing these two roles hasn't left me much time to sleep.
Where'd you get those cuts?
The Colonel.
He found out?
If he knew, I'd be dead already. No, this is his hobby. He's a sadist. He gets pleasure out of making people suffer. He's scum. Does it look that strange to you?
No. I'm the same way. Scars all over.
Can I see?
No. Where'd you get this one?
I got it after defecting to the Soviet Union.
I don't think so. It's older than that. Code breaking is a desk job. Where'd you get this kind of scar?
You really want to know? Well, too bad. A girl's gotta have some secrets, you know. But enough about that. You've gotta get going. The phase two trial of the Shagglehout is about to start, and it looks like someone might be coming to spoil the party.
Khrushchev?
His forces are on their way here. The Colonel is gathering his troops together to meet them. If we don't get a move on, the security will be even tighter than it is now. You'll need this key. It unlocks the door to the underground tunnel. Once you're in there, you can follow the tunnel to get inside Groznyj Grad. And take this, too.
What is it?
The food of the future. A well-balanced meal for the space age. It's good to eat some real food once in a while. I'll bet if I kissed you, you taste like a wild beast.
Do you know where exactly in Groznyj Grad Sokolov is located?
He's in the heart of the fortress, the weapons lab. The weapons lab is divided into three wings. There's the east wing, which houses the research facilities. Then there's the main wing where the weapons are assembled. That's where the Shagglehout is. Finally, there's the west wing, which is connected via a passageway to the main building. That's where Sokolov is. To get in, you'll have to enter the main wing from the east wing. Then, go through the passageway on the second floor of the main wing.
The west wing of the weapons lab. Got it.
There's just one problem.
Not again.
The west wing is protected by the highest level of security. You need to be Colonel class to get in.
Colonel class?
Here, look at this picture. Major Ivan Rydenovich Rykov. Pretend you're him.
How do I do that?
Steal his clothes. You look similar from behind. They won't know the difference. Your face might be a problem, so you just have to figure something out. He should be somewhere in the east wing.
All right. But how am I supposed to escape once I get Sokolov out of there? Command said you're supposed to have something ready for me.
And I do. There's a lake 30 miles north of here. I hid a wig there.
A wig?
It's a state-of-the-art ground effect vehicle.
A ground effect vehicle? I can't fly one of those.
That's okay. I happen to be an excellent pilot.
Taking off from a lake is trickier than it looks. It's not like riding a motorcycle. You've got to be more delicate.
Of course I will. You've seen how good I am with the bike, right?
Right. You handle the escape then. I'll head for Groznyj Grad.
Wait a minute. There's something I wanted to ask you.
What?
What's the story between you and the boss?
She was like a mother, and my master.
And your lover?
It went deeper than that.
Deeper?
Half of me belongs to the boss.
Do you love her?
No, nothing like that.
Do you hate her?
Does it have to be one or the other? Love or hate?
Between a man and a woman? You bet.
For 10 years, we lived and died together. You couldn't possibly understand.
And you think you can kill her now? That's your mission, isn't it? Assassinating the boss? Snake, is there anyone you like? Someone special?
I've never been interested in other people's lives.
You were interested in the boss.
She was different.
Really? How do you feel about me?
I should be asking you the same question.
Me? I can fall in love if it's part of the mission. Even with you. Snake? What's wrong? See you around, Snake. Take care of yourself.
What about you?
I've got to hurry back and play my other part.
Are you going to be okay?
Not sure. They're not stupid, and they know there's a spy. There's no way you could have gotten this far all by yourself.
Colonel, did he talk?
No, he died before I could get it out of him.
Wasn't the spy then?
Look at this.
A transmitter?
Exactly. Planted to keep someone informed of his location.
But does this mean Grannon was the spy?
Perhaps he was being used by someone else.
Perhaps. This man was our comrade.
Comrade or not, he's of no use to us now.
I don't approve of your methods.
I don't need your approval. I'm in command here.
And that nuclear shell?
Still feeling sore about that, are you? What are you gonna do? Report it to the authorities? This is war, Major. A cold war, fought with information and espionage. We must root out spies wherever they hide. It is kill or be killed. Potential threats must be weeded out. Your feelings are a menace to the unity of our organization. Someone is guiding the enemy's hand. A single man can only accomplish so much. Make no mistake, there is a spy among us.
But casting suspicion on our own comrades.
The C-3 explosives have been stolen.
You think it was the American?
No. He could not have reached this fortress yet.
Then who?
I'd be careful about suspecting your own men.
Boss!
Where have you been?
The fear and the end have fallen.
CIA dog? That leaves only the Fury. How can the legendary Cobras be beaten so easily?
He's good.
Fallen for him?
Don't worry. I'll take care of him.
What is he after? Must be more than just Sokolov.
America is out to destroy the Shagahat and get its hands on your inheritance. The Philosopher's legacy.
Impossible. The legacy, it...
Then they're out to kill me as well. Colonel, tighten the security on this place. He's coming here, I'm sure of it. I'm gonna get the Davy Crockett.
Boots. Make sure you polish them up properly.
I am the Fury! The flames of my rage will incinerate you. I came back from space. As I returned, I had one vision. The world set ablaze. And do you know what I saw there? Fury! A great and terrible fury at being alive. Now, you're going to feel the scorching heat of that horrible blackness.
Boss,
this is the end of the Copras. You've got to live on. You're the only one left. I'm off. To join the sun. Mission Control, do you read me? I'm coming home. I see the Earth. Thank you.
What can I say?
Thank you.
Sir!
Here it is.
You can count on me. What about the philosopher's legacy?
I don't know anything about that.
What are you? Are you trying to kill me?
What's the matter?
I know nothing, I swear it.
No one but the Colonel knows of the legacy.
I see.
No, don't! Oh!
Who's there?
You're the man from the CIA. What are you doing here?
I told you before, didn't I? I'm going to get you out of here.
A man of honor, just like your commander. But I'm afraid you're too late.
Too late? Don't tell me. The Shagahods.
Exactly. The final preparations for Phase 2 are complete.
Sokolov, what exactly is Phase 2?
To put it in technical terms, it's a composite range extension system for medium-range ballistic missiles. The Shagahod was originally designed as a tank that could launch nuclear missiles from any type of terrain. There was just one problem we couldn't figure out how to solve. The ICBMs we have today are simply too big for the Shagahod to carry. But the military would not hear of it. They demanded a weapon that could launch a nuclear missile directly into the American homeland. That is when I came up with the idea for Phase 2.
But there's no way you could load an ICBM onto the Shagahod. So how do you do it?
By accelerating the Shagahod itself.
Accelerating it?
In Phase 2, a rocket booster unit is attached to the frame of the Shagahod. The unit incorporates the same technology used in the Vostok rocket that sent Major Gagarin into space. Using this booster, the Shagahod can achieve a land speed of over 300 miles per hour.
That monster can go more than 300 miles per hour?
Yes. And from this state of accelerated motion, it launches a nuclear missile.
So, the Shagahod acts like the first stage of a rocket.
Yes, precisely. The range of the missile launched by the Shagahod thus increases from 2,500 miles to 6,000 miles.
6,000 miles? That's enough to strike anywhere in the United States.
Not only that, with the Shagahod, there's no need to construct giant silos like the ones used to house ICBMs. All you need is a runway about 3 miles in length, or its equivalent. And you can launch a thermonuclear strike against any location in the United States from anywhere in the Soviet Union. It cannot be detected by spy planes or satellites. It's a mobile fortress, capable of deploying in secret and launching its payload at any time.
A weapon from hell.
A completed prototype now sits in the hangar. At present, it is the only one of its kind. But Vulcan is planning to mass produce them based on that prototype.
and deploy them all over the Soviet Union.
Yes, and that's not the end of it. He's going to ship them to Eastern Europe, to Asia, to all the countries of the Eastern Bloc. Even worse, he intends to use the Shagohod as bait to foment armed uprisings among dictators, ethnic insurgents, and revolutionary groups throughout the Third World. His funds are nearly limitless. He could start mass production tomorrow if he wanted. The reason that tensions between East and West have settled into a Cold War is because each side fears the other's power. Deterrence. The idea of using threats to keep one's enemy in check is the perfect word to sum up this state of affairs. But the Shagohod goes far beyond the level of threat. It will render the concept of deterrence utterly meaningless. If such a weapon is unleashed on the world, it will not be long before all nations are engulfed in conflict. The Cold War will end, and the entire planet will be consumed by the fires of war. Vulcan and the Shagohod will be at the center of it all. So you see, it's already too late.
No. It's not too late.
What do you mean?
We've still got a chance. All we have to do is destroy the prototype and the whole facility before they can mass produce it. But just tell me what I need to do to destroy this place.
All right. The liquid fuel used in the rocket engine is stored in a tank. If you can blow it up somehow, some C-3 ought to be enough to blow the entire hangar to smithereens.
C-3? You mean that cutting-edge plastic explosive?
It could be molded into any shape. The bomb of the future.
Where can I get it?
There was some in the armory here, but it's gone now. It was stolen by a female spy who was here a minute ago.
Eva?
No, that's not her name. Her name is Tatiana. She made her way in here by becoming Vulcan's lover.
I thought she was your lover.
Mine? Oh, no. She is Vulcan's lover. This is my lover.
Who are they?
My wife and daughter. They're in America.
Now I remember. Your family is in the custody of the CIA. How long has Tatiana been here?
Only a few weeks.
A few days before the Virtuous mission, then.
She said that Khrushchev sent her.
What did you just give her?
All of the experimental data for the Shagohod. Please, it is essential that you destroy the Shagohod.
I will, but first I've got to get you to safety.
No. I'm not going.
My mission is to rescue you.
Leave me.
Sokolov!
Khrushchev has abandoned me. I cannot return to my country. I would most certainly be sent to the gulags.
What about the US?
Yes, I once thought of that. My family's waiting for me there. But even if I fled to the United States, I would once again find myself creating weapons of mass murder. In the end, it doesn't matter where I go. I am still a weapons scientist. To be honest with you, I'm tired. Every day I help create things that should never be used. Things that should never have existed in the first place. Every day, without sleep. Without a word of praise from others. And my creations do not even benefit mankind. They are merely the tools of politicians. All I wanted to do was build space rockets. But it was not to be. The space race between America and Russia became the prey of politicians. The space race and the arms race are one and the same.
Missiles, rockets, what's the difference? Scientists are always being used. Please, watch over my family.
Major, what are you doing here? I've been waiting for you in my room.
Who are you?
Don't play dumb with me. If you think you can fool me, you're sorely mistaken. I know the Major better than anyone else. I come here looking for Tatiana, and what should I find? But a greasy freebooter.
Fairy disguise. It's gonna rub off on you. And then you'll lose sight of who you really are. Stay out of this!
See why they call you the boss. What was that? Some kind of judo?
No, it's called CQC, a basic form of close quarters combat. He and I developed it together.
Splendid. I'll take it from here.
Are you going to kill him?
Of course. But first, I will make him pay for hurting Ivan. Tell me!
Stop it!
Who have you been talking to?
He doesn't know what you're talking about.
You'd better start talking.
Please, stop this!
Who is Khrushchev's lapdog?
How can you do this to him?
I know you gave the data to someone.
Never do that.
You!
You monster.
I guess he's dead. Now then, I hope you'll prove more entertaining than he was. But first, let's take a look at your body, shall we? What a beautiful body you have, like a newborn baby. But not for long. Well then, let's get started. What is your target? Is it the Shagohod? Or Sokolov? Or maybe it's the Legacy? Answer me! Who is helping you? Who let you in here? Whoa. You're a tough one, but even you must have your limits. And I am a patient man. Here's where the fun really begins. Body carries an electric charge of 10 million volts. Let's see how you like this. Now answer me. How much does the CIA know? They're after my legacy. Aren't they? Your real target is the Philosopher's Legacy, isn't it? Yes, yes. Let yourself go. That's what I want to see.
It's no use. He's not going to talk. He's been trained not to break. Trained by me.
Admit it! We're after the location of the Legacy! The secret fund established by the three great powers during the two world wars. That's what you're looking for, isn't it? $100 billion, divided up and hidden all over the world. And you're looking for a record of where all that money is hidden, right? No matter. Philosopher's Legacy is safely in my possession, in the underground vault of Groznyj Grad. You'll never lay a finger on it. What's this? A transmitter? Who's responsible for this?
I am. I planted it on him to keep track of his movements.
Why?
So the Cobras could ambush him.
If they knew where he was gonna be, they wouldn't have gotten themselves slaughtered. It pains me to do this, boss, but under the circumstances, I'm afraid I must ask you to show me some proof that you and he were not in collusion.
You don't trust me. Is that it?
Not that. But he is your apprentice.
What do you want me to do?
Let's see. Cut out his eyes. I don't like those blue eyes of his. There's nothing more important to a soldier than his eyes. You made him a soldier, and now you will unmake him. Yes, it'll make for a touching display. He's all yours. Do it! Ruin him! Just as he did the Cobras.
Ow.
What is it, Tanya?
He suffered enough.
Well, well. Why are you protecting him? That smell. Tatiana, you're the spy.
What are you talking about?
I know that smell.
Stop it!
Taking a fancy to her, eh, Ocelot?
No. I have no interest in this woman. I want to test her. I'll let this be the judge.
Do as you like.
Go.
Satisfied now?
Well, that was refreshing. Come, we're going to my room.
So you survived the Colonel's torture, eh? Watching this has made me realize something. It's really not that bad. It's the ultimate form of expression. You got lucky this time, Tatiana.
Run!
I've prepared an escape route for us. Go out and head west. Pass underneath the connecting passageway and go north. You'll find an open manhole there.
You're...
Quiet! Go through the manhole down into the sewers. The door at the north end of the sewers is unlocked. You can use it to get outside the fortress. I've got your equipment. We'll meet up later.
Eva.
But I can't get too close to your cell. You'll have to figure a way out of there yourself. I'll be in touch.
Hey, you're not such a bad guy after all. I guess not all Americans are dogs.
You mean it?
Yeah. You know, before the war started, I used to live in America. I even had a wife and a kid.
You must be pretty lonely.
Yeah, I am pretty lonely. Really lonely.
What's your kid's name?
Johnny.
Johnny. Nice ring to it.
Really? You like it? Well, if you say so, I'll believe you. Actually, my name is Johnny, too. All the firstborn sons in my family are called Johnny. My dad's a Johnny, and my son's son will probably be a Johnny, too.
A whole clan of Johnnies.
Why do we have a Cold War anyway? Our two countries used to be such good friends.
Yeah, I hear ya.
I just want to see my family again.
Must be rough.
Yeah. Not as rough as you have it, though. Well?
Don't suppose you could let me out of here?
Huh? I can't do that. Hey, don't you go getting any funny ideas. If you try to escape, I'll have to shoot you. I've said too much. I gotta go.
Snake.